But I think that the way, so therefore it is getting unduly politicized, you know, in this very peculiar manner. But having said so, I would like to completely disagree with A, what Lord Desai said, that the UPA government has actually been, you know, benefiting the poor through redistributive policies. It is the UPA 1. And you compare in the UPA 1, the Rural Employment Guarantee Act was passed on the second year of the government. This government is trying to pass the food security bill just 6 months to 7 months before the election campaign starts. That is the big difference. This government has done absolutely nothing for the poor. That is the big problem. The third point which I want to make is that this way you are pitting this whole thing, that this food security is for the poor, the middle class is going to bleed.
Why not?
I think is very far-fetched and
why not?
Totally oversimplified.
Why not? Why not? Because you don't want to look at
please
it.
Hear me out.
No, why
hear
not?
Me out.
Why, no, why is the middle class
no,
feeling
please,
the pinch? You don't agree. No, you don't agree. The middle class feels the pinch.
Please.
Tell me, Prasenjit Bose, when the RBI keeps the interest rates high, who is hit the most? Whose cost of borrowing increases? Has our per capita income stagnated? Are people
please
buying cars anymore? Are people losing
point.
Jobs?
Number one.
No, why don't you
one,
want to accept the reality?
I don't think, first of all, that there is any contradiction between spending more for the poor and doing much more for the economy through
certainly there
of
is.
Jobs and, you know, providing jobs to middle class.
Certainly there is.
There is absolutely no contradiction.
Certainly there is.
In economic terms, there is no contradiction.
Sir, certainly there is. Then you are not sure. No, then I contest your economic terms. Then I contest your economics. I contest your economics then, Prasenjit Bose.
No,
our domestic consumption has fallen. I contest your economics.
Allowing me to make this argument or
No, I'm contesting your economics.
No, wait. This is no way to have a debate.
But Prasenjit Bose, household consumption spending. You are ignoring the middle class. You are taking an anti-middle class position. I'm asking you today, are you aware household consumption spending has fallen down?
You please allow, hear me out for 2 minutes. Have some patience. Have some patience and hear me out for 2 minutes.
I've heard you. I give you 30 more seconds. Yes.
First of all, this food security bill is going to cost 1,20,000 crore. Already the government spends over 80,000 crore in food on food subsidy. It has been spending so for the past 3-4 years. So it is an additional expenditure of 40,000 crore. An additional expenditure of 40,000 crore is 0.5% of your GDP. It doesn't take much to finance that additional amount. Actually, the BJP is in a way right.
Okay, tell me, how do you finance it?
Basically,
give me some ideas. How do you finance it?
Schemes.
Give me some.
So don't make this entire thing about.
Meghnad Desai raises his hand.
The money is going to be spent.
Meghnad Desai raises his hand. He's counting on you. Meghnad Desai is countering Prasenjit Bose.
Yeah. Now listen. Chidambaran in the budget allowed only 5,000 crores for food security. If you're going to spend 45,000 crores,
10,000.
That means the deficit is going to get worse. Unless you say, where are you going to cut something else so the deficit is not worse? If the deficit gets worse, the rupee will fall further and you will have more
consider
inflation.
Consider this fact.
Is the government prepared to do that?
Consider this fact. Rashid Kidwai.
You know, this is all.
Rashid Kidwai, consider this fact, this question.
I don't know where all these connections are coming from.
Well, you know, you don't want to draw the connections. That's the problem, Prasenjit. You don't want to draw the connections. I'm drawing the connections.
It's in the budget.
I'm drawing the connections.
It's in the budget.
I'm drawing the connections. I am saying today.
What is the current expenditure
on the budget? No, you don't. You're not willing to look at the real perspective.
No,
Prasenjit, you are not looking at the reality of your own country. In your own country, if you stop looking at it in a skewed way, if in your own country, and my question is to Rashid Kidwai, unemployment has risen 10%+ in the last 2 years. People are getting unemployed and losing jobs. I lost the link there with Rashid. People are losing jobs, Rashid Kidwai, and you want to go ahead with this kind of profligacy?
Yeah.
Will people forgive you for this?
I don't know, the problem is that average congressman doesn't understand economics.
So what?
Nobody
why should
understand.
I suffer because
political
of it?
Political parties are absolutely dishonest. You look at, look at BJP. Why is BJP not opposing food security bill? If Mr. Narendra Modi is all powerful, BJP should oppose it in parliament. They are not opposing it. You see, in Chhattisgarh they are doing it. Food at various kind of subsidies are given by everybody. Shivraj Singh Chauhan is giving it. Everybody is giving free power. So the whole idea of economic management is quite alien to political class. This is a cold reality. Now, what is Sonia Gandhi trying to do? I'm just explaining. I'm not defending Congress Party. I'm explaining Sonia Gandhi. What is Sonia Gandhi's motto? Sonia Gandhi's motto is economic right, social left. Let there be money.
No. That's not Sonia Gandhi's motto. That's not Sonia Gandhi's motto.
Food is a very powerful weapon.
No. That's not Sonia Gandhi's motto. I remember Chintan Shivir of January 2030. Like to remind Bhaktacharan Das, Congress Party said, we are the party committed to science, technology, inclusive innovation, jobs and creating growth for the youth of India. Tell me, Bhaktacharan Das, I'm taking the first caller.
But last year, who cleared FDI in retail?
I'm taking the first caller. FDI, that FDI same retail, youth of Congress the same party. Youth of India will ask you, yes. Am I yes, expected
it,
to
it,
live?
It has been the... It has been, Mr. Arnab, it has been the motto of the UPA government, and UPA government is trying its best to deliver this. But at the same time, the effect of the global economy, the downtrend system of the global economy is there. Who
sure.
can deny that system?
So ridiculous.
And no, Piyush Goyal countering you. Counter from Piyush Goyal. Piyush Goyal.
Ridiculous.
Piyush Goyal.
Arnab, just three,
ridiculous.
Four things. This government, when they don't find any other excuse, earlier it used to be the Pakistan hand, now it is the global factors, but the fact is the entire collapse of Indian economy is because of the Congress hand and nobody else. After all, no global factors are responsible for 7 lakh crores of projects being stuck in different stages of approval. Foreign hand is not responsible for interministerial turf wars or for the huge corruption scams that one after the other this government is inflicting on the nation. The fact is, we are for genuine food security. Even the Supreme Court, the World Bank and their own planning commission has complimented Gujarat and Chhattisgarh for the very effective implementation of the PDS model. We don't give 25 kilos like the Congress is proposing. We give 35 kilos and the total, can I complete some videos? Can I complete, gentlemen? I've listened patiently to all your comments.
No, but why is BJP not opposing food security bill?
Bhaktacharan Dasji, I listened patiently to you. I can also attack you if, directly while you are speaking. Arnab, the Chhattisgarh model of PDS, which has come in for widespread acclaim all over the world, the World Bank, the Supreme Court, the Planning Commission, we spend only 1200 crores a year. And we give food security to 2.5 crore people.
But Piyush Goyal
has 120 crore people.
But Piyush Goyal,
we could have provided food security effectively.
Piyush Goyal, why don't you? I feel
at half the value what this government
Piyush Goyal,
is talking.
Piyush Goyal, you're dodging something. You're dodging something. Tonight, one of our panelists has asked you clearly.
I'm not dodging anything. I'm saying we had the right model. If only they had
learned the lessons from Gujarat, you have the right model.
We could have provided 35 kgs against 25.
You have the right model. No, you have the right model and you have the right argument. But do you have the political courage, Mr. Piyush Goyal, to question the economic feasibility of the food security bill? Why speak about the implication
exactly
for states? Why
don't you?
Why does Narendra Modi not speak about the implications for the economy? On the he likes to talk the
but
economic
exactly
language. Why
Narendra
is he not
Modi
talking about the implications for the economy?
But that's exactly what Narendra Modi has raised in this letter. He has said that when the government is saying poverty is coming down. Today, of course, Bhaktacharan Das has acknowledged that poverty has not come down.
No, he's not said that.
Under the UPA, finally, we've heard their spokesperson say that. But the Narendra Modi has raised the same thing in this letter, which I'm sure you have read, that which government first sets 81 crores as a target without setting eligibility criteria. Even the parliamentary standing
first
committee
caller.
Said, let's have eligibility criteria.
No, I'm asking you.
Second,
what am I asking?
Then why 81 crores?
Thursday, will you oppose it?
Then will you oppose it? Will you oppose it on Thursday then?
We are asking for amendment to make it a good bill, sir.
No, why don't you oppose it? It's not about good or bad. You can't afford
sir,
it.
We are opposing it in its present form.
Do you? No.
We are bringing in the amendments which will improve the bill.
It's not about form. The question I asked you was about courage. I am saying you don't have the money now. You acknowledge we don't have the money, but you won't oppose it. So you want to keep one foot on the left.
I just showed you, Arnab.
So,
Arnab, I just told you without corruption,
You can give food security for
to the poor. No, one second, I wish like you there was no corruption, but there is corruption. You're avoiding my question. Rashid Kidwai putting a counter to you. Rashid Kidwai.
They are frittering away the money.
Rashid Kidwai putting a counter. Go ahead, Rashid.
See, that's how Bhakta Charan Das said 80,000 crores is available.
Well, I have understood your point of view. I am saying if it is so bad, if it's a bad piece of legislation, why are you supporting it? You can block it very easily in both houses of parliament.
I just explained to you, so don't seem to understand English. I just said we are not supporting it in its present form. We want the correct amendments which we have already given our notice for
you
amendments
are
in the Lok Sabha.
You are moving amendments.
Counter.
What,
counter. Two hands go up.
Is ready to accept your amendments.
Two hands going up. Meghnad Desai, go to you and then I'm taking the first caller. Lots of callers. So the whole country is very much involved in this debate. Meghnad Desai, who are you rebutting?
Since all parties are supporting this food security bill, including BJP, they need to explain to the people how they are going to pay for it.
Yeah,
there is
well said.
Not enough money to do this. And BJP and every other party has to say what they will cut by way of 125 lakh crore expenditure under which budget. So that the food security bill will not.
Prasenjit Bose says a small amount.
A problem.
Prasenjit Bose says a small amount. Prasenjit Bose says a small amount.
Arnob, let me say.
It is not a small amount.
I think that anybody who are expecting any economist or any analyst who is expecting political parties in an electoral democracy to oppose a food security legislation in a country which has the highest concentration of hunger-stricken population in the entire world is barking up the wrong
tree. So why did they discover it now?
How do you expect?
Prasenjit, why they discovered it
what
now?
What were they doing for 67 years?
What were they doing? Exactly. What were they doing for 67 years?
Congress has
You asked that question.
No, that's not the question.
I'm saying you are asking the wrong question.
No, I am asking.
You asked that question. What are you doing about it for so long?
No, Prasenjit.
But don't oppose food security.
Prasenjit Bose, what
are you opposing food security?
Prasenjit Bose, what I am asking is that is great idea, bad timing. Sorry, great idea, terrible timing.
So you say that, but you are opposing food security legislation per se.
I am saying great idea, terrible timing. I've been saying this from the start. There's
don't
a time
you want
for everything.
Hungry people to have more food.
There is a time for everything. There is a time for everything. This is not
Arnab,
that time. This is like going.
So you attack the timing.
Of course, I'm attacking the timing.
Opportunism, not only of the Congress.
I must apologize. I'm going to the first caller.
Have the cake and eat it too.
First caller, who's been holding for more than 15 minutes, and therefore I always defer to the viewers. I always defer to the viewers for our panelists. Our first caller today is Rajesh Arora, and I think you're calling from Jaipur. Rajesh,
yes,
good evening. And are you asking a question or making
evening.
A comment?
Good evening, Arnab.
Good evening.
Am I audible?
Yes, very much so.
Is it in shameful, Arnab, that even after 67 years of independence, the Congress still believes that this much of people are not able to earn two times a meal? Why not this much of amount being spent on creating jobs so that the people earn and buy food?
Okay, good
and
question.
Why the government has woken up during the election time? Why not nine years back?
Superb question. Rajesh Arora, I always say the viewer asked the best question and that proves it. Bhakta Charan Das, that question came from Jaipur and it wasn't from the BJP but from a News Hour viewer. Why didn't you answer to him?
That is why government of India brought Mahatma Gandhi Narega and large-scale rural employment is there. And people, poor people are empowered to purchase their commodity, their materials, and they are having a good life at this moment. But still then there is poverty situation. We must bring our people capable to the extent of what you say at the
middle
class level.
Rebut from JDU. JDU rebutting you. JDU's turn to rebut. Pawan Verma, go ahead.
No, I'm just saying that while food security is a laudable goal, I agree with your caller that we need to create the employment and create income levels. Why is it, I ask you? And all parties need to answer this. Agriculture has been the most neglected sector of our economy, growing still at the Hindu rate of 2 to 3% per year. Today you need to get a quantum boost in the productivity of agriculture. Because otherwise subsidies, however well-intentioned, are not going to be able to deliver.
See, this is nothing but...
For instance, in Bihar, I can tell you without being partisan on this, in the last two financial years, paddy cultivation by itself has grown by 55%.
Don't advertise the Bihar government. I know you don't miss any opportunity to advertise the Bihar government, but I won't let you do that on the news tonight.
By the way, I said beyond partisan politics.
What's it?
Beyond partisan politics.
Yeah, Arnab, just to inform your viewers that in the NDA regime from 2000 to 2005, 6 crore new jobs were created, employment opportunities. Whereas in the first 5 years of UPA, the so-called high growth years, only 27 lakh jobs were created. This government believes in entitlement and not empowering the people.
Sir, I throw a challenge at
and
you
just
too, Piyush Goyal.
For Pawan Verma's knowledge,
Piyush Goyal,
Shivraj Singh's government is giving double-digit agricultural growth.
Your time, Mahatma Gandhi,
you are all advertising.
Involving Mahatma Gandhi,
why are you making this so partisan, Piyush?